In the time which is mine, I would like to invite your attention, please, to the New Testament as we continue our examination homiletically of the words of Jesus Christ, our Savior. I want to invite your attention to the Gospel according to John. John's Gospel, chapter number 2, starting in verse number 1. You shall have found it, say amen. If you need more time, say wait. The Gospel according to John, a familiar story. And I'm reading from the New Revised, the Standard Version of the Bible. You'll find these words. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee. And the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what concern is that to you and to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now standing there were 6 stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to them, "Fill the water jars with water," and they filled them up to the brim. He said to them, "Now draw out some and take it to the chief steward." So they took it. When the steward tasted the water that had become wine, he did not know where it came from. For the servants who had drawn the water knew. The steward called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and then the inferior wine after the guests have become drunk. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this, the first of his signs in Cana of Galilee, and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. But you have kept the good wine until now. Jesus did this, the first of his signs in Cana of Galilee, and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed. I will preach on this MLK worship service Sunday from the subject, Miracle Makers. Miracle Makers. Let's go to God in prayer. Father, where I am, you brought me. What I know, you taught me. What I have, you gave me. And what I am, Lord, Lord, I'm depending on you. Can't do nothing till you come. This is your servant's prayer. I ask it in Jesus' name. And all God's children said, amen. We have a seat in the presence of God. Miracle makers. There is a question that looms large behind most disciplines that study human behavior and its impact. This question is not one that is new, but has been asked throughout time and perhaps will be asked throughout eternity. This question may be reason for and give rise to perhaps the reason for religion in the first place. This question is not about life after we live. That question is not one that is always considered by all human service disciplines. This question is much more difficult to answer, but here it is, and you can help me figure it out. The question is, see how y'all missed that? This is the question that has been asked and answered in various ways. Say it another way. When you see something wrong, is there the possibility that what we see can be changed to something else? The prophet asked the question, can a leper change his spots? Somebody else asked the question, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Somebody else asked the question, can African Americans really y'all like I'm healthy? The question is one that is rooted in a desire for transformation. Preach, boy. It is one that is rooted in our desire to see real change. Because for many of us, we are tired of things going like they go all the time. Do I have any witnesses here? There are some of you who are content with status quo. But there are others of us who look at situations and dare to ask the question, can this be changed? Don't matter how bad it looks, we're not concerned about what others say, we're not caught up in all possibilities of a situation. All we want to know is there the possibility that what we see can be changed? Is change possible? Now you do know, don't you, that there's a difference between a change and a cover up. Oh my God. Of sounding sexist, and that's not who I am. Let me just say that that the $1 billion beauty industry is not specifically focused on, can I help somebody, on plastic or prostate surgery. But what it does focus on is, can you hide blemishes? Y'all better get out of the company, but I know what I'm talking about. So if you have wrinkles here, and I know black don't crack, but it will crack eventually. But if come on somebody, if you have wrinkles or false teeth, and I'm not just talking about women, I mean men. Come on, somebody. You can always go to a doctor or to a surgeon and have them put you under, and they can inject Botox and change all of that. Or they can go ahead and say, just use this mascara, use this treatment, and you can always blend it into your skin, and you can do that. But all of that, even the Botox, is simply a cover-up. too old, stored in 30-gallon barrels. Jesus simply turned the water into wine. Not sure if it was mustard down or stuff or not. Not sure if it was Pinot Noir or Pinot Grigio. Not sure if it was a rosé or a Cabernet Sauvignon. Not sure if it was a white Zinfandel or a red Zinfandel or a Moscato or a Moscato Piazzi. All I know is he turned water into wine. That suggests to me that Jesus' first miracle wants to serve notice that I have come not to cover stuff up, preach for, but I've come to change things. I've come to bring about change in the world in which I live. I'm glad. That's the easy part of the text. Because to affirm Jesus as a miracle maker, that can turn water into wine, that's good. But what it does, it puts us in the posture of being a spectator to the wonder-working power of the Lord. Clifford Matthews, it causes us to be spectators who sit and wait for Jesus to do something for us. Preach good, Matthew. Talk to the ball now. It puts us in a posture where we're always looking for him to do something for us. Because every now and then, Wall, we need a miracle. And we know that if Jesus is a miracle worker, we go to Jesus to get a miracle. And we always stand in a posture of expectation for Jesus to do a miracle. Now, I'm not saying that he won't. But I am suggesting. And your Christological examination of the text before us today is limited to the work of Jesus and Jesus' work only, then you have missed what it means to follow after Christ. Because if all you're looking for is Jesus to do something for you, then you miss it out on the greatest pleasure of life. And that is that not only is Jesus a miracle maker,
the door. stop looking for Jesus to fix it, and we need to stop telling Jesus, here I am. I'll be the miracle maker. But when I do it, I give you all the glory.
Tired of seeing things continue like they always have.
but I'm committed to be the miracle man.